Good morning. Welcome to the Oregon Fly Fishing Blog. I'm Tony Torrance. We're going to tie a little rogue fly this morning, traditional divided wing double hook. This is called a red ant, taking us back a few years. This is on a 3582 BR made by Mustad. These hooks we can get. We have some at the shop. Get them while you can.
Daiichi 7131, also a good double. Okay. It's an up eye instead of a down eye.
These, I would strongly encourage you, if you're going to fish these, please pinch the barbs on them. You're dealing with quite a few wild fish in the population down there, and we want to get those fish back in the water safely. We've got a red tail. It's nothing more than Chinese saddle hackle. Get that tied in. Next, we're going to use several strands of peacock curl. I'm going to just take that, cut the tips off evenly. And this is how you reinforce this material to make it a little stronger. Make a loop. Bring it around one time. Grab your favorite hackle pliers.
Those are pretty fancy.
These are old.
They work.
Back in the day when you and I were filling jars with lacquer. So we've got that spun. It's reinforced with thread. And I'll build this up a little bit. Bring it around. Cross it over. So I've got a nice little ball. I usually take the thread around this a couple times and then cinch it up. Now if I want to keep the symmetry on the body, I'll just bring it up the shank, come back down. I'm going to tie in some red wire. You know, the red wire really doesn't do much other than to keep this fly intact. When you're catching these half pounders, they've got great little teeth and they will tear your fly to shreds. So this just reinforces things. Some red floss. Bring this up the shank here and cover that. Red wire comes up. You know, you can fight as much as you want or don't want. Just keeps that floss from just getting toasted after about two fish. Fairly simple pattern, which is nice to tie something a little simpler. The wing on this is red fox squirrel, and we're going to stack this material real well. See how even the tips are on that. The stuff is very slick, can slip, and get the wing length I want. Hold it from the rear, bring it around a couple loose wraps, and then get everything snugged down. And I really put a lot of wraps. Now, you know, we talk about wing pull and that sort of thing, and people get all crazy on how they tie wings in. I just keep it fairly simple. I just tie it in there, put a decent number of wraps. And if you use a thin head cement that penetrates the thread, it'll lock that material in. I'm just going to shape this a little bit so the final head's not too big with my cautery tool. Okay, so now I'm going to get this finished off a little bit before I go and divide these wings out. You know, fairly large head. You know, it's a fishing fly, traditional. So now I'm going to turn this a little bit so maybe you can see. It's going to make it a little harder on me, but we'll get her done. So I'm going to pull that wing up and get it away from the shank and divide it. And I'm really yanking on this to get it to spread out. Okay. couple, three wraps, get that one out. Come around behind. We're just crisscrossing through this material. If you want to get crazy, you can also take this, and I'll just show you real quick. Tighten up the material a little bit and just bring it around the base a couple times, like that. And again on this one.
It just kind of cleans it.
Yeah.
A little bit.
Yeah, it snugs. It tightens up the wing a little. So we've got that. Finish with there. Make a whip finish on here. Get a nice glossy head on these, always makes them look real pretty. And there you go.